is the best thing, is the best thing I've ever done. Is the best thing, is the best thing I've ever done. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Falling in love with Jesus.
Amen.
Ain't like no other love I know. And I'm so glad about that. Because he don't love me like everybody else love me. He loved me regardless.
That's right.
Amen. And he loved you too. No matter what. Amen. Y'all remember that. Somebody loves you. Amen. Amen. Now we will be welcome. We will welcome our guests by our own, the anointed. The appointed. What else, Vera?
Approved.
Approved. Pastor of the great Rock Hill Baptist Church. Give it up for our own, Pastor Raymond B. Young.
Well now, good morning, Rock Hill. Thank you so very much. At this time, we are favored to have in our company this morning, Sister Kim M. Reed, Sister Ruth Johnson, and Nakisha Tippins. I hope I pronounced your name correctly. And any other visitors that I did not call, if any of you wish to greet us this morning, you may do so at this time in your own fashion.
Good morning, Dr. Kimberly. I'm the neighbor's grandma.
Amen.
Prayer. Thanks to be in your presence. I'm enjoying this one.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
We thank you so very much for being here, sis. Thank you. Any other visitors? Yes.
First of all, I bring you greetings from Trinity Tabernacle in Portsville, where my pastor is, Pastor Henry Dixon, and I've been invited by Ms. Jada as well, and I am truly enjoying the service.
Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. We thank you all. Come on, give our visitors a round of applause. We thank you all so much. Let's find another. Yes?
Just I'd like to also welcome my classmates, also Jada's grandmother, Ruth Johnson.
Amen.
Ruth Johnson and I'm Jada's grandmother, and I just thank God for life.
Amen. Thank you all for being here. Amen. Let us all, with the members of Rock Hill Baptist, the members of Rock Hill Baptist, will you all please stand as we give our visitors a Rock Hill welcome. Truly welcome. Please come again.
Amen. Communications and our announcements will be given now by our most efficient secretary, Sister Reed. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Jehovah Baptist Church is cordially inviting us to join them for Pastor and First Lady Polk's first pastoral anniversary that will happen on Sunday, March the 10th, 2019. Reverend Frederick D. Robinson, the pastor of Holy Covenant United Church of Christ in Charlotte, North Carolina, will be a speaker, and Dr. Kenneth L. Miller, pastor of Kingdom Vision Ministries from Riverdale, Georgia, will also be a keynote speaker. Greater Emmanuel AME Church is cordially inviting us to their annual tea program, which is Sunday, March the 17th at 3 o'clock p.m. The speaker for the occasion will be Reverend Judy Elaine Tharr from Greater Emmanuel AME Church. Mitten Lane Holiness Church is cordially inviting us to their 74th church anniversary celebration. It will take place on Sunday, March the 17th at 4 o'clock p.m. The special guest speaker will be Reverend Terrace Green from Pilgrim Baptist Church in Pineville, South Carolina. Also, the Cherry Hill Classroom is having an oyster roast. It's an all-you-can-eat event, and that will take place on Saturday, March the 23rd at 1 o'clock p.m. and will go until 4:30 p.m. and it will be held at the Cherry Hill Community Center. As always, these items will be posted on the bulletin board in the back. I ask that you would avail yourself of the announcements. As a reminder, Pastor Young will be the guest preacher at Greater Howard AME Church in Buckhall for their Ash Wednesday service. The service begins at 7 o'clock p.m. If you are riding on the bus will leave promptly at 6 o'clock p.m. Please be at the church no later than 5:45 p.m. Also, Pastor Young will be the guest preacher at St. James AME Church in McLennanville on Sunday, March the 10th for their 50-state rally, which will take place at 4 o'clock p.m. The church bus is tentatively scheduled to leave at 3:15 p.m. Just as a reminder, our annual Family and Friends services is upon us. Services will be held Wednesday, March the 13th through Friday, March the 15th, and culminating on Sunday, March the 17th at 7:30 p.m. Please remember that when you're filling out your church envelopes to put your member ID number up in the right-hand corner. And if you would be so kind, we would ask that you please not seal your envelope and please do not put a total on it. Again, if you do not know your member ID number, please see Sister Helen, our financial secretary. Also, Pastor Young is still asking our youth to participate in suggesting topics for sermons for Youth Sunday. If you're interested in doing that, the forms are in the back and the box is in the vestibule as well. Also, there will be a meeting for the women's ministry, the missionary ministry, as well as all of the choirs, excluding the youth choir, on March the 24th, immediately following service, and it'll be held here in the sanctuary. The meeting will cover information that has been outlined in our revised bylaws for each of these ministries. So it's important that you stay on the 24th immediately after service. Also, midday prayers every Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. Please take note, there will be no Bible study this week, March the 6th, and next week, March the 13th. Bible study will resume on March the 20th. As always, I ask that you continue to keep the individuals listed on our bulletin and the prayer list in your prayers throughout the week. And I believe, Deacon Warren, you have an announcement as well.
Good morning, Rock Hill.
Good morning.
Just to add on to what the church secretary said, we're in our final stages of our revised church bylaws. We've got a schedule out for each ministry to review the bylaws and ask questions. So when it comes down, the pastor decides that we're going to have a vote on it, we won't have so many questions at that time. Everyone will have a chance to look at the bylaws, review them, and have feedback. So we're hoping that you abide by the schedule that she has given. It's been a year now since we've been revising these bylaws. So we pray that we know God has been with us.
Amen.
When we revise them. So please take heed to them and look at them carefully. Thank you.
Amen. Good morning. Amen to the men, amen, who are on the men ministry. Amen, we have a meeting next, amen, week. I believe it's 10 to 11. Please, men, if you are on the men ministry, we are looking for you. Amen, we're supposed to be the leaders of the church.
Amen.
And we expect you to please try to make some of the meeting. Amen. We understand that you can't be here all the time, but, you know, please try to be here on next Saturday from 10 a.m. to 11. Amen. Thank you, man.
Yes. Wonderful things he's done.
Amen.
This Wednesday, as was read in the announcement, this Wednesday we will not be having Bible study. Wednesday, please be at the church no later than 5:45. The church bus will leave at 6 o'clock. We are journeying to Howard AME out in McClellanville in the Buckhole section of McClellanville for a Ash Wednesday service. We will be supporting Howard AME with the Reverend Leandra Stoney is the pastor. So this Wednesday is no Bible study, but I would love to see us. Let's go out and support Pastor Stoney. Well, Pastor Stoney will be closing our family and friends this month. So she is coming this way, but we're going to see her first. And next Sunday afternoon, the church bus will leave once again immediately after worship service. Immediately after worship service, we're going out to St. James AME to render a word for them on their 50-state rally program. We're going to leave from here and go out to Buckshot's Soul Food Restaurant in McClellanville, get us a good meal, and leave from Buckshot's, and we're going back to St. James AME Church. So on next Sunday, we will be leaving immediately after the worship service for that occasion. It was just announced that our family and friends is quickly and it's fastly approaching. Team 4, are y'all in the house?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. Is Team 4 on fire? I don't know. Y'all don't sound like it, but Team 4, I want you to know I'm leading the charge. I'm already starting my giving towards family and friends today. All of the teams, anybody that's giving to family and friends, you are allowed to put your money in your envelope, mark the amount, family and friends. Please put your team number on the envelope if you put money in the envelope. Make sure that you get in touch with the finance person of your team, whoever is keeping the record of your team, so that you can make sure that your team finances matches what Sister Helen has on her records. If you're going to contribute, once again, to family and friends by way of using your envelope, please put family and friends F and F on your envelope and put the amount and put your team number on your envelope. Then get with the person on your team that's keeping up with the finances and let them know that you have contributed to the family and friends. We still in love.
Yes, sir. Amen.
All is well.
Amen.
I'm going to return you to the hands of our very capable presider.
Amen.
I am Team 4's financial person.
Amen. Father, ma'am, could I say something to you, Brother Gene Chavis? Please be prepared to have the financial report for the men's on next week. Please. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. I would like to take this moment to say thank you to my wonderful pastor and First Lady and all of Rock Hill, especially Minister Warren and Deacon Warren and Minister Perkins and Deacon Perkins. They really kept up with me the whole time I was gone. And Rock Hill, thank you for asking about me and checking on me. Thank you for your prayers and your concerns and thoughts and the calls, everything while I was away. God is good. The family is well. The children are well. And we're just going to move on. We're going to keep moving forward because that's how God has designed us. Amen. Amen. So thank you for your prayers that gave us strength as we went through the transition of my children's father. Amen. Amen. So now, give it up.
Yes.
for Rock Hill Senior Choir. Yeah. After that, we will hear the word by our own Pastor Raymond B. Young. Amen.
Amen.
And there is a word from the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Come on, choir. If you live right belong, if you live right heaven, oh heaven, if you live right heaven, if you live right heaven, if you live right heaven, oh heaven, if you live right heaven, don't give up your fight heaven, gotta fight with all your might heaven, if you live right heaven, if you live right heaven, if you live right heaven belong, oh heaven, oh if you live right heaven, keep your neighbor right heaven, don't you give up your fight heaven, belong, oh heaven, oh if you live right heaven, stay on the Lord's side heaven, in his word always abide heaven, oh, oh heaven, oh heaven belongs, if you live right heaven, if you live right heaven belongs, oh heaven, oh if you live right heaven, keep on running the race heaven, one day you'll see God's face heaven, oh, oh heaven, oh if you live right heaven, oh if you live right heaven, if you live right heaven belong, oh heaven, oh heaven, 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 oh heaven, 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 oh heaven, heaven, heaven belong, oh heaven, oh if you live right heaven, oh if you live right heaven, treat your neighbors right, heaven belong, oh heaven, oh heaven, heaven, heaven belong, heaven.
heaven belong. If you live right, heaven belong. If you live right, heaven belong. Oh, heaven. Oh, heaven, heaven, heaven belong. Heaven, heaven, heaven belong. Heaven, heaven, heaven belong. Oh, heaven. Oh, if you live right, heaven belong. Don't give up your fight, heaven belong. Fight with all your might, heaven belong. Oh, heaven. Oh, heaven, heaven, heaven belong. Heaven, heaven, heaven. Oh, heaven, heaven, heaven belong. Oh, heaven. Yeah, heaven, heaven, heaven belong. Heaven, heaven, heaven. Oh, heaven, heaven, heaven belong. Oh, heaven.
If I treat my neighbor right, if I love right, live right, walk right, talk right, be right, get right, heaven, heaven, belong, belong to me, sweet old heaven, sweet old heaven, over there in heaven. They tell me that the streets are paved in heaven. They tell me that the angels sing hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to his name. In heaven, no sorrow, no crying, no pain. In heaven, no working, no bills. If I live right, if I live right, heaven, heaven. Oh, y'all ain't excited. Y'all ain't excited. Y'all ain't excited. If I let him lead me, if I let his word take control over my. One day, the death angel will stop by to see me. I can see me as I see him. He's coming to me. I'll welcome death with open arms because I live right, preach right, love my neighbor right. I'm going home to live with Jesus. Heaven belongs to me. Thank you, choir. Hey! Hey! I already feel him in this place. Heaven belongs to me.
Thank you, God.
Good morning, Rock Hill. We greet you in the marvelous and matchless name. Jesus, the only Savior,
yeah.
The only Messiah.
said, we greet you in that name.
That name.
We're going to read from Nehemiah chapter 8. We want to give honor to these fine preachers. All these preachers, absent Reverend Thelma Perkins. To these fine deacons. To this great senior choir, give them a round of applause. Thank you, choir, for taking this ship out in deep waters. How about that praise team this morning? Give it up for the praise team. These fine musicians. Deacon Dingle, our drummer, is out of town. Him and his lovely wife, but the Lord has a ram in the bush. Come on and give our drummer a round of applause. Hallelujah. Those of you in the sound booth, we had some issues this morning, didn't we? Y'all notice every time we have baptism here, the devil tries to raise his ugly head. Oh, but we baptized her anyway. That's all right. Satan, your assignment has been canceled. Thank those of you in the sound booth along with our great ushers.
Yes, the Lord is our rock.
I honor my lovely wife, Sister Vera, for putting up with this preacher. Girl, I'm praying for you. You got to put up with me? Yeah, yes, yes, Lord. There is a God. There is a God. And to our candidate, Sister Jada Rucker, come on and give the Lord some praise for what he's done in her life. God has been so good. Sis, we praise the Lord for you. We magnify his holy and his righteous name. Amen. I see my cousin is here this morning. We are almost like brothers. Brother John Smalls, thank you for being in the house this morning. I'm going to read into your hearing from the book of Nehemiah, the 8th chapter. Nehemiah chapter 8. And I'm going to read verses 1 through 3, and then we'll skip down to verse 5 and 6. Nehemiah chapter 8, those of you who can, will you please rest upon your feet. Nehemiah, the 8th chapter, and I'll begin reading at verse number 1. And it reads, and all the people gathered themselves together as one man into the street that was before the water gate. And they spake unto Ezra the scribe to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded to Israel. And Ezra the priest brought the law before the congregation, both of men and women, and all that could hear with understanding upon the first day of the 7th month. And he read therein before the street that was before the water gate from the morning until midday before the men and the women and those that could understand, and the ears of all the people were attentive unto the book of the law. Skip with me to verse 5, please. And Ezra opened the book in the sight of all the people, for he was above all the people. And when he opened it, all the people stood up. And Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God. And all the people answered, amen. Amen. With lifting up their hands, yes. And they bowed their heads and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. Thus ended the reading. If I may use, for some would like to speak with you, tell you it is time for genuine worship. It is time for genuine worship. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, your man, servant, and preacher, stand before these, your people. And Lord, I ask that you come and feed your man, servant. Take young out of young and hide him, Lord, behind your cross. As I open my mouth, let it be all of you, Lord, of me. Come on now and use me, Lord, as your instrument. I'm emptying myself that you might fill me up. Come on and preach now. Then, Lord, move through the pews. Ready them that their hearts might receive, that their ears might hear, and their minds will be regulated. Give me courage and boldness to preach with power and conviction. And when you're through in this place, I'll be careful to give your name honor, glory, and the praise, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Forgive me, I forgot to say thank you again to all of the family and friends that came out to support Sister Jada this morning. Thank you all for stopping by the great Rock Hill Baptist. It is time for genuine worship. Whether the Bible is making any nation today may be debatable. One thing is sure, the scriptures help to make the nation of Israel. Israel is a people of the book as no other nation has been. And the church today would do well to follow ancient Israel's example. When God's people get away from loving, reading, and obeying the word of God, they lose the blessings of God. If we want to be like fruitful trees, we must delight in the word of God. Psalms 1 and 2 says, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. Stop by the Tell Rock Hill Baptist Church. If we are going to engage in true worship, one of the first things we must do is we must delight ourselves in the word of the Lord. We must get excited when the book is open. We must begin to move when we know that preaching is about to come forth. We ought to set aside some time through the week to open our Bibles and begin to meditate day in and day out. Get down in the word, and we must delight in the word of God. I'm telling you, it is time for true or genuine worship. The Bible defines the word genuine. Webster says, if anything is to be genuine, it cannot be counterfeit. It must be authentic. To be genuine, it must be real. Descending from the original stock and pure in breed. I wonder this morning if we have anybody in the house whose worship is not counterfeit. Do we have anybody in the house that your worship is genuine? Your worship is authentic. Your worship is real. It is time for genuine worship. It is time to get real. It is time to be authentic. If your praise is counterfeit, oh, I wish we had a few worshipers in the house. Wish we had some folks that know what God has done for them in their lives. Don't mind worshiping, regardless of who's looking. I'll worship because he's worthy. up your worship.
Amen.
From the original stop this morning. The original stock. See, the original stock is Jesus on Calvary's mountain. If your worship comes from seeing Jesus as he went up Golgotha Hill, as they stretched him wide and they hung him wide, if you know that Jesus died for your sins,
amen,
that ought to cause you to enter into genuine worship. The Bible dictionary defines worship as reverent devotion and allegiance pledged to God. New Testament worship was characterized by joy and thanksgiving because of God's gracious redemption in Christ. This early Christian worship focused on God's saving work in Jesus Christ. True worship was that occurred under the inspiration of God's Spirit. In John, the 4th chapter, verse 23 through 24 says, "But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such worshipers to worship him." Anybody in the house tonight want to worship the Lord? Anybody came here this evening to give God a praise? The Lord says, if you're going to worship him, you must worship him in spirit and in truth. Anybody in the house tonight is a true worshiper of the Lord Jesus. He is seeking those that will worship him. It is time for genuine worship. Verse 24 says, "God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth." I tell you, it is time for genuine worship. Let us carefully examine our text for this occasion. Here in Nehemiah, the 8th chapter, beginning at the first verse, somebody ought to say, preach the text.
Preach the text.
Anybody want to hear from the text this morning? The text says here in Jeremiah and Nehemiah, chapter 8, verse 1, it reads, "And all the people gathered themselves together as one man in the street that was before the water gate. And they spake unto Israel, who was the scribe, to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded. The people came together as one man. All the people had the same intentions, the same motives. They all had the same goal, and they shared in the same purpose. You ought to ask your neighbor, do a pew check right now. What did you come here for? You ought to ask somebody that's sitting next to you, did you come here this morning to worship the Lord? See, when they came together, they were as one man. They had one mind. They had one goal. If somebody that's on your pew didn't come this morning to lift up the name, to praise the Lord, you ought to tell your member that's on your pew, excuse me while I worship. I came to worship. My worship is not counterfeit. My worship, it is for real. My worship is authentic. My worship is from the original stock, because he died on Calvary's cross. My worship comes from heaven. I feel him. I feel inside. My worship will make me move sometimes. My worship is genuine. It is time. It is time for genuine worship. Tell somebody I want to praise him because it might be the last time. My worship, when I look back over my life, I can see where he brought me from. Worship in the morning. Worship in the afternoon. Worship. Hey! Hey, hey. After church. Huh? After church. Is to have genuine worship. We ought to come together as one man. If the church gonna have genuine worship, we ought to come together on one accord. If the church gonna have genuine worship, I cannot say I don't like this preacher. I don't like this preacher. Don't like that preacher. But if the church will have some genuine worship, if we begin to love one another, care for one another, I see God showing up in this place. Worship, worship. There were as one man. Now in the text, y'all don't mind if I preach the text to you. The people asked the preacher, y'all, to bring the book of the law. Isn't that in the text?
Yeah.
I just read the text. The people asked the preacher to bring the book. I wish we had somebody in Rock Hill today that wanted to hear from the book. Somebody ought to say, preach the text. I want to hear somebody say it. Say, preach the text. The people told Ezra, we don't want to hear from you. We don't care what you think. We don't care about your opinion. But oh, Brother Ezra, will you bring us the book and open the book and preach from the text? I wish we had some folk in Rock Hill Baptist that wanted to hear from the book. When the book is opened up, sometimes the book will come down your street. But I don't care what the book says. If the book says, I believe it. It's in the book. You ought to preach the text. I want to tell some preachers, stop holding back on the word of God. Preach the book. Let them hear what the book says. They told Brother Ezra, bring us the book. Preacher, can you do something with the text? We want to hear what thus says the Lord. Wonder if we got anybody in Rock Hill like that. Well, all I got for you is what they say in the book. Y'all don't mind if I tell y'all what they said in the book. I'm going to verse 2. I know somebody still is already angry right now. Verse 2 says,
in the book.
And Ezra the priest brought the law before the congregation, both of men and women, and all that could hear with understanding upon the first day of the 7th month. Now, make note that the congregation consisted of men and women.
All right.
But then the Bible said, and all that could hear with understanding. That tells me some parents brought their children to the worship service. I don't know why y'all press y'all way to service and leave them chilling when they're going and when they're not going and when they're going to do this and when they're going to do that. You're really not at 1033 Old Black Oak Road. I don't know what you got going on at your place, but I'm going to tell you now on Sunday morning, it ain't got to be children. If you under the roof of 1033 Old Black Oak Road, Lottie Dottie and everybody. Now, you don't have to go where I go, but you're going somewhere. I don't care if that's mama and daddy. If you under my roof Sunday morning, mama going to church too. He said everybody that could hear with understanding was there. Let me move on to verse 3. Y'all done got quiet on me. Somebody ought to go home today and tell whoever you left it. Whoever you left there this morning, when you get back today, you ought to tell them, now, next Sunday, you can't stay in here. You got to go to church. Let me move to verse 3. Y'all don't like that, but that's in the book. I didn't make none of that up. That's in the book. You better read yours. Now, mine might have a misprint, but it's in mine anyway. Verse number 3 says, and he read therein before the street that was before the water gate from morning until midday for the men and the women and those that could hear with understanding. And the ears of all the people were attentive unto the book of the law. The Bible says that the preacher preached from morning. Vera, are you listening, honey? I want my wife to get this part. Y'all don't mind. Vera, the preacher said, the Bible said, the preacher preached from morning until midday. I want y'all to notice it never said that anybody left the worship service. If the preacher preached for 20 minutes in this time, somebody said he preached too long. He preached too long. But I'm so glad that somebody wanted to hear from the book. And if you're preaching from the book, preach. Preach and preach. Preach it when they want to hear it. Preach it when they don't want to hear it. Preach it when they say you preach too long. Preach, preach, preach in the morning. Preach in the noonday. Preach. Hallelujah. Hey, glory. From morning to midday, from sun up till noon, he preached and he told them what thus says the Lord. Somebody say he preached too long. But I'm so glad there's a word from the Lord, and the word, it must be preached. Hey, hallelujah, hallelujah. Preachers, I don't know about y'all. But I jokingly talk about time when I'm preaching. Jokingly. Deep down on the inside, time don't mean nothing to me when I'm preaching. You know when I'm going to stop preaching? I'm going to sit down when the Holy Ghost stop giving me feed me, I'll feed you. I'll put it on your plate. If your plate is running over, get you a saucer or a larger plate, put it under your plate, and you can catch the overflow, because I'm preaching from the book. Hey! Notice now, the Bible gives no information about anybody leaving the worship service. See, now I'm talking about genuine worship. See, for genuine worship, you come in here for that purpose. Well, my thing is, if you got things so pressing that you can't stay, well, stay home. Listen, listen, I want you to understand this. I want you to get this. You can't worship and be genuine in your worship with your mind all scattered on all other kind of stuff. Preacher preaching, and you looking at your watch. Where you going? What you got time for? I'm so glad that Jesus didn't wear a watch. When Jesus got to preaching, he didn't care how long it took. He preached, and he preached, and he preached some more. I feel like preaching now. Hallelujah. Where we get this from? About you, but when I come in for worship.
Amen.
I ain't playing with this thing.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but I don't make plans when I'm on my way to church.
Yeah.
Who does that?
Yeah.
I'm here today. I don't have no place else to be but at Rock Hill this morning. And whenever I leave here, I leave it. Now, whatever is left in the rest of the day, I'll take part of. But I will not schedule.
Say that.
Anything that's going to hurry the worship experience. I don't know about you, but we got Bible study on Wednesday.
Yeah.
I don't plan stuff for Wednesday. I tell the folks on the job Wednesday, and I'll tell the fool of the job on Wednesday now. I'm going to do what I can do, but at a certain time, I got to get up out of here because it's time to go to Rock Hill Baptist.
Amen.
Well, they worship. Let's follow the text now. The Bible says the ears of the people. Now, I want y'all to get this part. This is what the Bible says. We're attentive to the word of the Lord. See, that's genuine worship.
Yeah.
The ears. Webster's dictionary defines the word attentive as giving your attention to. Is there anybody here giving their attention to the words that are coming out of the preacher's mouth? Do I have your ear this morning?
Amen.
In churches today, while the preacher is preaching, folks are texting. People are passing notes while the preacher is preaching. People are daydreaming while the preacher is preaching. People are overly concerned about what other folks are wearing while the preacher is preaching. And some got the nerve to be fast asleep while the preacher is preaching. But the Bible says all the people, their ear was attentive to the words of the Lord. Anybody here want to hear from God? Is there anybody here that's listening right now? Is there anybody here? Wake up your neighbor that's next to you and tell your neighbor, he's preaching now. Wake up, put your phone down, stop texting, wake up, stop daydreaming. You ought to listen to the words of the Lord. Let me go to verse 5, y'all don't mind.
Come on.
Ezra, open the book in their sight. Somebody ought to get excited. When the preacher opens the book. For he was above all the people. And when he opened up the book, all the people stood up. You know, preachers can learn from Ezra. Preachers should open the book.
All right, say that.
Preachers need to preach from the book. Preachers should study the book. Preachers need to know the book. And most of all, preachers need to live the book. I stop by to let somebody know it's in the book. You can find it in the 66 books. Well, the Bible says here, when he opened the book, the folks stood up for the reading of the word. To stand for the reading of God's word is an act demonstrating a willingness to listen, believe, and obey what is about to be heard. What does it mean when you stand up? Y'all standing in Rock Hill? Because it's become our tradition.
All right.
When the word is read, well, in the Bible, in the biblical sense, when the folks stood up for the reading of the word, they were demonstrating a willingness to listen, then obey. The next time you stand up for the reading of God's word, you ought to know what you're doing, understand what you're saying. If you stand up, you're telling God, I'm willing to listen. I'd like to know how you're going to listen and text at the same time. How you going to listen and you pass a note in church? You know what, I hate preachers sit next to me in the pulpit when I'm not preaching. I hate preachers.
Trying to talk to you.
What are you tapping me for? I'm trying to get the message.
Leave me alone.
Would you, if you tap me one more time? I don't know what you came here for, preacher, but I want to hear the message. My ears is attentive to the words that are coming out of the preacher's mouth. I want to hear the word. We up here in front of everybody. We carrying on a conversation in the pulpit. Don't you know everybody can see us, preacher? And I got to know who those are, though. sitting in church, talking about people outfit in church, and you came here to worship? How the world are you worshiping with all this worldly stuff going on in the house of the Lord? I'm almost finished, y'all. Y'all done had your stomach full of meat. Verse 6 says, and Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God. And all the people answered,
amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. And amen. Amen. And amen. If you preach, preacher, if you preach, the folks will respond. If you tell the world what the Lord has done, if you tell them what Jesus has said to you, I see somebody holding up their hands, saying amen. Preach, preacher, I need to hear. Preach anyhow. Amen means so be it. That is the truth. Amen means that I agree. You ought to preach. You ought to preach till they lift up holy hands. Preach. Tell somebody say amen. Preach anyhow. Tell somebody go down on bending knees and tell the Lord, Lord, I love you, Lord. You're so good. You've been so great. Genuine worship. It is time. It is time to worship him in spirit and in truth. Genuine worship. Say amen. You ought to move sometime. Say amen. You ought to wave your hand every now and then. If you got some Jesus down on the inside, you ought to feel him. He's moving on the inside. You ought to stand to your feet. Stand to your feet as we open the doors of the church. We take you by letter. Christian experience. And candidate for baptism. Genuine worship. Genuine worship.
My God.
We worship it in spirit and in truth.